It's your girl Griselda B. I am live on my Facebook channel and live on a Strong Arm Radio. Tonight is going to be a very, very good, dope night. We have one of Miami's biggest coming through tonight, dropping some jewels with us, you know. As y'all can see, it's no company tonight, but I'm all alone. But it's definitely going to be a great show until the guests get here. So, you know, we're going to start off with getting with a little topic I wanted to touch bases on. You know, I be on social media a lot. And then I be seeing a lot of ins and outs. So me, everybody already know I'm opinionated. You know, everybody already know I'm very opinionated. You know, and I like to put my two cents, as they would say, in on different topics, what's going on. So tonight I just definitely want to touch bases on showing your dog some love. You know, we got to normalize giving our people who we really fuck with, our dogs, like our day ones, our, however you want to describe them. We got to normalize giving them their flowers while they're here. I notice like people will wait till something happened to a person or a person passed away, and then they want to talk about how they love the person. Oh, you this, you that. Like, don't be like in fear to show that true genuine love for the person you really mess with. You know, like, we don't never know when it's going to be. Everybody so busy, focused on self to, you know, they forget to acknowledge those who really there for them, who really in their corner. So that's what I want to touch bases on. Like, that's your dog, you know, you vibing with your dog, that's your day one, go ahead, you know what I'm saying? Give them their flowers while they here. Shout out to everybody that's on this live video as well. I want all of you guys that's tuned in to the Griselda B Show right now, I need y'all to go ahead and share this live. Tell a friend to tell a friend, the one and only Griselda B, the girl with the big mouth. I am live and I am ready for tonight. Like I say, tonight going to be a very, very good night. Shout out to Stefan. He the guy with the production. He making all this happen. You know, if you haven't already, I want you guys to go ahead and follow the Strong Arm Radio on Instagram and follow the Griselda B Show Instagram. You know, for all exclusive interviews behind the scenes of what's going on with the show and everything. So, you know, just to piggyback on what I was talking about, like, you being around a person, you know, that's your dog, that's your rider, you with them every day, you got to start giving your dog their flowers while they here. Let them know how you appreciate them. Appreciation is not always in the form of finances. It be the little things that your friend do for you that you should acknowledge, you know. Anything, no matter what it is, down to the smallest thing, you know. Like I posted today on social media, it's the principle of things that people, some people think that it's simple, but it be the principle behind a lot of shit. You get what I'm saying? So, to say the least, let's normalize. Like, you know, that's your friend, you fuck with your friend. You ain't got to be scared that your friend to outshine you. You know what I'm saying? To salute them, get them their flowers while they here. Stop waiting till somebody pass away. Wait till something bad happened to somebody. Then everybody want to act like they really fuck with that person that hard. Because they may be deceased. You know, they got into a bad situation. Now, that's your dog. But when your dog was here, you weren't really giving your dog that attention like that. So I just wanted to bring that, you know, to the forefront of everything. To let people know we got to normalize giving our close friends, you know, our family members, you know, just our support system overall. We got to normalize giving people their flowers because you never know when you'll be in that situation that you will maybe need that person. You know, I want to see what y'all got to say about that. Like, chime in with me. Let me know how y'all feeling. Like, do you normalize giving your friends their flowers while they're here? A lot of us just tend to overlook, you know what I'm saying, what people do for us, and we get it confused with thinking that it's a given, that people supposed to, nobody's supposed to do nothing for neither one of us. You know, it's like people doing it because they really fuck with you, so you can show your appreciation in any form, any fashion. Like, people, we have to get away from thinking everything is a financial thing. Money don't always cure it. Sometimes a simple thank you, sometimes a simple I appreciate you, you know what I'm saying? A simple good looking out. Shit, little simple like that is worth something more big. So I wanted to touch on that tonight and let everybody know where I'm coming from with that. Because even me, myself, you know, I tend to overlook a lot of things that people there for me. Not that I'm just feeling like it's all about me. Shit, sometimes I just be in my own zone and I forget to recognize the ones who really there for me. You know, I tend to just feel like, shit, yeah, they supposed to do it because of, shit, they fuck with me, they supposed to do it, but it ain't really that. You know, you have to start showing that true, genuine love to people who really got your back. You know what I'm saying? Even the simple, anything simple. Me, I'm more sympathetic now, so I start to show my love to people. Even if I'm just texting them, like, just checking in on you. Like, I love you. Hope your day going well. Anything, because you really don't know what people be going through. And something just as simple as just checking in on you could make people day, you know? So, again, let's normalize giving our people, the ones who really in our corner, let's normalize giving them their flowers while they are here. Let's big them up. It don't take away from you to put the light on your dog. That ain't gonna dim your light because y'all gonna shine together. You know when people say it get lonely at the top? It's definitely lonely at the top if you ain't really trying to bring nobody up with you. So put that light on your dog sometime. Let your dog know, like, shit, when I'm on, we on. Everything good. You get what I'm saying? I'm gonna bring you up when I go up. So, you know, no big deal. Shout out to everybody that's on this live too. I want y'all to share this live. I can see the comments here. So shout out to the King Loso. You know, shout out to Yvette. Love Yvette. Steven Greg. Facts. Amen. I do. Gotta give you why they here. Yeah. Erica Durant. 100. Shout out to everybody, you know, that's tuning into this live. Again, I can't stress it enough. I want you guys to tell a friend to tell a friend that we are live. Shed is live. Go follow the Strong Arm Radio on Instagram. Go follow the Griselda B Show on Instagram. Go follow me, the one and only Griselda B on Instagram. If you already don't follow me, take some time off to go follow me and come right back. You know, we're going to have the phone lines open a little bit later once we get deep into the show. But we got one of Miami biggest coming in tonight. You know, he's going to drop some jewels for us. I won't just yet announce who he is, but definitely, you know, tonight gonna be a great night. Thank all of y'all for tuning in. Everybody's engaged. And that's what we do. And I want to say again, shout out to Stefan, the man with the production. You know, he making all of this happen. We gonna keep it locked right here on the Strong Arm Radio. What's going on, everybody? Talk to me. Let me know what's going on. You see that on there? Shonda Boo, what's up? The realest chick, Griselda B. LaTanya Crum, what they do? If people don't hear, use the reaction button, it will put on the timeline. Okay, well, show them how to use the reaction button. Far as what y'all can do to help the show, get out there. I need y'all to share this live. Let everybody know that you tuned in to the Griselda B Show. You know, let me read some of those comments. Can you scroll on that? Emily Dunlop, how you doing? Shout out to LaShea Brown. And I want to give a big shout out to everybody who going through something and they healing behind the scenes that people don't know. You know, you going through something that people don't even know you going through, but you know, you still walking every day, chin up, head high. You just doing what you can, you know, to stay above ground, man. Shout out to all y'all out there that's going through silent wars that we don't know nothing about. I'm here to give y'all hope, to let y'all know you just got to keep striving, you know, and it's going to get better for you. That's the type of shit I be on, period, boy. So we're going to go ahead on and get into a video.
Got the vision.
So we're going to go ahead and get into this video. Yeah, I turned the radio down because you put the music back.
No, I didn't put it back.
I was checking.
Make them say, the trap making money, everybody in the hood eating.
tell by the way we judge.
Who's that with the bros at Lil Haiti in the building? You heard? Ah!
You can keep it moving, dog. I'm straight. Make them say, Show love to the hood. You a hood nigga. Keep it 1K. Make them say, paid by the blow the bitch all in one day. Man, I say, it's still chop or die. Give a fuck what I hate or gotta say. Man, I say, stand 10 toes, keep the pistol on you riding all day. Man, I say, middle finger to the L. Give a fuck what I hate or gotta say. I just be stacking up, flip like a spatula. The foreigners be backing up. Money, I'm racking up. You ain't never seen ball mains like D. I fit 500 in these jeans. Like 30 on the chain, half a brick on my wrist, little bitch.
Got a lot of money, yeah. Got a lot of money, yeah. If you got a lot of money, yeah. If you got a lot of
make
money,
make them say, The trap making money, everybody in the hood eating good. Make them say, The hood got fear, you can tell by the way we judge. Make them say, If it ain't about the money, you can keep it moving, dog, I'm straight. Make them say, Show love to the hood, you a hood.
We're in that beat right now.
Make them say, this ain't no picture, boy, ain't no edit.
Ain't no edit.
All these seeds around me, come get it. Talking crazy, boy, I'm pathetic. I done whooped you once, done whooped you twice, ain't still talking shit. How to snatch your bitch, then I fuck your bitch. Nigga, damn, you a bitch. My hitters is on that, walking on niggas like doormats. Flipping the bird, it's the format. Ballin', ballin' on you bitches like Kobe. Boppin', boppin' on you niggas like Kodak.
Okay.
Trap house going real dumb-dumb. Hey. Ice cream, and the crackers going numb-numb. Dang. Got the young shooters ready with a lum-lum. Meet your bitch, eat me up like yum-yum, ayy.
Got a lot of money, yeah. Got a lot of money, yeah. If you got a lot of money, yeah. If you got a lot of
make
money,
make them say, The trap making money, everybody in the hood eating good. Make them say, The hood got fear, you can tell by the way we judge. Make them say, If it ain't about the money, you can keep it moving, dog, I'm straight. Make them say, Show love to the hood, you a hood nigga, keep it 1K. Make them say,
got the pigeon.
So okay, we back. Shout out to Frank Castle. That was his new video, make him say Frank Castle will be in the building tonight, you know, live on the Griselda B show, one of Miami's biggest rap artists coming out of Lil Haiti, putting on for the city. So I want y'all to tell me what y'all thought about that video. I thought the video was very dope, you know, knowing Castle, he making moves. You know, he doing his thing all up the coast, starting at 305, you know. He working, the grind is unmatched. Like, his grind is so unmatched. Frank doing his thing, you get what I'm saying. Shout out to Frank Castle. What y'all think about that video? I think that video was very dope. I think it was more like, it fits his style. Y'all know Frank Castle. You know, I want y'all to go ahead and drop those fire in the comments. Drop the fire emoji, you know, to let me know how y'all think of that video. Frank Castle is one of the guys from Miami. He doing his thing, like, he's everywhere. You can follow his Instagram at FrankCastle13. You know, we represent Big Z or whatever. What y'all feel about that video? I feel like that video was very, very dope. I feel like it was authentic. You know, I feel like it was more of him, you know. I think that's giving Miami style. I feel like it's giving more, it's its own wave. He's not too caught up in the cliche trends. You know, I feel like Frank Castle, that guy, you know, being in the Miami music business, coming from down here in Miami, it's like you got to be one of them to even get the people's attention, you know. And Frank, he one of them, you know, he's one of them. Like I say, his grind is so unmatched. He's a hard worker. I want y'all to go ahead and tag Frank Castle on this and let him know how y'all feel about his video. You know, the video was dope. It's giving me so much of Miami. You know, his vibe is different. He give me like that boss vibe. Like, he's more bossy. He ain't on all of that, like, that drill music. He giving it to you real. Like, he make you feel like, what is it that he talking about? Everybody that's tuning into this live, I thank y'all for shouting me out. Congratulations on the show. Michelle Pollard, Naomi Vaughn. I thank all of y'all for tuning in. If you have not done it, I want you to go ahead and do so. Share this live. Tell a friend to tune in to the Griselda B Show each and every Tuesday, 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. live every Tuesday. We're going to get into a topic tonight. And I want a lot of y'all to elaborate on this topic. I want y'all to comment, you know, on the comments. If you feel, you could call in the radio station and let us know how is it that you feel about this topic. You know, I need you. Yeah, y'all messing with Frank Castle video. Yes, Frank Castle putting on for the city. Shout out to Castle, Big Z. You know, Frank Castle 13 representing the Little Haiti. Shout out to all the Zoes out there, you know, putting on, doing their thing. The video is very dope. Like, Frank Castle dope. He will be in the building tonight. You know, he gonna give us a little up close and personal about him, letting us know what's next and everything. So tonight's topic, I want to go ahead on and get into tonight's topic. Tonight's topic is like, it's got to deal with more so of the finances mixed with a little bit of control. Do you think a man rather date a woman that has more money than him or less money than him? So I will be the first to chime in on that topic. You got that, Stephon? So do you think a man would prefer to date a woman that has more money than him or less money than him? A lot of y'all might seem like, what kind of question that is, but I'm going to be the first to chime in with the topic. Most men like women with less than them, because I said most, so I don't want everybody to go ahead, you know, and bite my neck off. Most men like women that has less money than them because it becomes a control thing. Some men like to control women with money. Some men have like ego issues that, you know, my woman got more money than me, so she really won't listen. And what brought that topic about is I was scrolling through Instagram, and I seen on Instagram a topic was like, I need me a chick that's broke so she'll listen. So I'm like, you know what, that's kind of interesting, because he was a guy who posted that. And a lot of guys, in my eyes, me, I feel like they like a chick that they can control, because nowadays it's more so about they gonna date you with how much money you got. So men feel like, as long as they got that bag, you get what I'm saying, it's a sense of control. Shout out to Jonathan Reed, he said match my hustle. That's what I'm talking about. I wonder, do y'all ever sit back and think, like, do Jay-Z and Beyonce, like, do they have money issues? Like, they both in a bag, they both got money, like, they on a whole different platform. So what y'all think? Do men like money? I mean, like women with more money than them or less money? How do y'all feel about that? Okay, Linda. Linda joined in and said, it really don't matter who have the most money. I mean, to you, Linda, it probably don't matter. To you. But I know guys who have more money than his mate, guys tend to control a mate with money. Some guys with money feel like they could do whatever they want to do because they'll pay their way out of it. Look with Lil Baby and Jada. Lil Baby do what the hell he want to do. He got money. For every time he get caught cheating, he come back with two Birkins and a new car. So right there tells you, like, you know, I'm not saying that Jada don't have no money, but men like to control women with the money. Stephon, you can move the comments up a little bit because I can't really see all the comments. The other way. Yeah. Yeah, just like put it in the middle. Or you can minimize my screen.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah. I'm looking at it. Ladette Miller, he doesn't have to work so hard. I think it all depends on the man. Sheree, I think it all depends on the man too. I mean, men really like to control women with money. They do. But they also, certain men like women that's got less money than them. And certain men like women who's grinding. I think my opinion, that a man will prefer to date a woman with less money than him. Because that's just me. Everybody different. That's why it's an opinion. Men's like to date women with less money than them because certain men feel like they could do what the hell they want to do. Like, if you catch me, okay, I'll make it up to you with a money gift. I'll go buy you this or I'll go do that. And a lot of us women, including me, I was once there, we tend to let money control a situation. So you could catch your dude hard down into something and he could come back and give you $10,000 and you forgot that you caught him cheating. So in my opinion, yes, I feel like men rather date a woman with less money than him, opposed to a woman who got more money than him. Because if the woman got more money than him, ain't no way in hell she going to listen to what he got to say. She queen. Ladette Miller said, a man want to brag on his woman. Oh, my baby got that bag. It's true. You know, my man to brag on me that I got that bag. But that still don't mean that he don't want to be superior. All men want to be superior. All men want to be king. So I just feel like money, financial wise, a man rather date a woman with less money than him because he can manipulate the whole situation. Money rules. Money rules the nation. So I just feel like, yeah, a man, that's my opinion. It's true. They love a woman who they can manipulate. And once he can't do that, that's what I'm saying. That's how I feel. Shout out to Didi LeBron. Shout out to you. I'm with you, Didi. That's what I'm saying. They use the money to manipulate the woman. You look at it all the time. Like, we not here to discuss Lil Baby and Jada. But she keep catching him. And what he keep coming back with? More money, more money, more money. New bag, new bag, new bag. New car, new car. It done got old now. So now she just like, shit. It don't faze her no more. Like, yeah, I'm done with the whole situation. So yes, we know Lil Baby got more money than Jada. We not saying that Jada not in her bag. But he has more money than her. So that's me. All the facts are there. Men like women with less money than them. Regardless of, some men will get on here and say that it's not so. But men likes to control women with the money. Simple and plain. They love women who they can manipulate. And money is a big old, money could help manipulate a lot of situations. So what y'all feel about that conversation? Y'all could go ahead and hit us up at 786-801-0031. Hit us up, call in, and let me know. Do you think that men prefer to date a woman with more money than him or less money than him? Okay, Yvette says some men feel like they not a man if they not making more money than a woman. So the relationship always want to be a problem. That's what I'm saying. Like, some men be ego struck. Some men be ego struck. Like, to know that your woman got more money than you, how you gonna tell her what to do? Because if she a strong woman, she a real boss chick, she independent, and she got a bag, why she gotta take your shit? Most women take a lot of men's shit because the men have more money than them and the men could manipulate the situation with the finances. Simple. Some men will disagree. Some men be like, oh, like Jonathan said, match my hustle. Some men be like, oh, I don't got no problem with my woman making more money than you do. You got more money. I mean, you got a problem with her making more money than you. Angela Perry say, a man with money controls the situation, sad to say. Which is true. I'm telling you, we don't see no men on here, only one man. And a lot of the men is tuned in, and a lot of them, they watching, but they didn't click the live to actually be showed on the live. Sheree Ellaby, some men love to be in control, and some men love for women to take care of them. Yeah. So, money make men feel superior. You know, every time you get on social media, and men know what causes us women to flock to them, because it's the perception. You see him jeweled up quite naturally, you're thinking he got a lot of money. So when he try to get at you, he's speaking in money. So he looking like, okay, yeah, he could seduce you with the money. He like a woman that he can have more than. Okay. I don't really... What's your name? May Diogene. She said, I got verbally abused when I started making more money than my ex. Which is true. Let me give y'all a situation. I ain't gonna call no names or whatever, because I ain't here to put nobody in shame, man. I really don't give a damn about the man anyway. But as long as I was down when I was in that relationship, it was one of my older relationships. As long as I was down and he had more, it's like everything was going good, because I had to really do what he say. Then I got level equal. It's like things tend to start showing its true colors. But once I exceeded, it's like all hell broke loose. Every time you turn around, it's a different problem. Every time it's like, oh, you got more money, you know I'm fucked up, you don't want to help me out. But when you had more money and I was fucked up, you was like bird feeding me. That's why I always put into my mind, in a relationship or going into a relationship, I got to make sure I'm good. Because at any given time, the guy could pick up and he could leave, and then you'll be stuck. Or you'll be stuck to deal with some shit that you won't even, like, you won't even consider dealing with. Like, if you know you depend on your mate, well, I'm going to say your man, because this is just strictly for the women. If you know you depending on your man, and your man got that bag, and you in a situation where you can't leave, you got to accept everything that comes to you because you need that man help financially. You know, and a lot of men tend to thrive off that. They know they got you boxed in, that you can't leave them. So they gonna do whatever the F they wanna do. Cause you got to stay and you got to accept it. So once you start to get yourself together, they gonna start to do everything to pull you back down and make you get back into that same place. Okay, there go a guy, Michael G Body. I don't have a problem with my woman having more money than me. Cause a real boss. I can't see the rest of the comment. You can minimize me, but put it up. Okay. Because a real boss woman is going to take a penny and bill a pound. Any respectable, accountable man is going to always respect an independent woman, because she's what makes the house a home. Which is true. A lot of men, you probably one out of a million, Michael. I'm not saying men don't. Shout out to my mama, Mae West, on here too. Hi, Ma. I love you. So listen. I'm not saying that all men rather date a woman with less than him. But majority of you men, y'all want a woman that has less money than y'all, because you like to manipulate and control a situation. It's just no way around it. Name one woman you knew that was in her bag, had her own going on, had way money than her dude, put up with his shit. Name them. We look at Halle Berry all the time. Halle Berry can't keep a man. Halle Berry keep getting remarried. Why? She don't have to listen to him. She got more money. But then you go back to a situation with Jada and Lil Baby. She don't have more money than him. It'd be hard for you to step out that zone when you dependent on that one person. Me, I'm the type of guy, like, I want to break even. Even though if he got more money than me or I got more money than him, either way you flip it, I still want the respect to be mutual. Money make you disrespectful. Especially if you going to feel like you can do what you want to do, because your money going to get you out of it.
GB, you leaving Lil Baby or not?
am I leaving Lil Baby?
Yeah.
If I was in a relationship with Lil Baby,
yeah,
I would have been hard dad. I don't care what Lil Baby got. I'm the prize.
So ain't no price. Ain't no. You don't have no price on your faithfulness.
A price
on man faithfulness.
My faithfulness can't be bought.
Okay.
Why? I'm gonna let him maneuver me with money. I'd rather walk away with nothing.
Say it with
and build chest. Myself back up than to let a man control the narrative on me because of money. And I'm only speaking like that because of I was in that situation before.
Mm.
But I always used to say, once I get like Kanye and get my money right, it's over. I will not let a man control me with money no more.
Facts.
Never. That's the old part of me. A lot of men like women who they can control. If y'all go look at Justin LA boy profile, he put on there too, oh, I got to go find me a woman that ain't got no money, couldn't be some money, don't listen. Like, they don't listen. Shout out to Andrea Green. I'm the price to give in that girl, that woman. Period. And don't care how much money you got. You can't control me, baby. I was in that before. You get what I'm saying? Men with money, y'all like to control women. It's hard to control a woman who got her own everything. It's hard to control a woman who got her own hustle. She may be down for that moment, but a hustling woman, a boss chick who know how to get that bag, she gonna bounce right up. And a lot of men end up losing good, great women because they want to control with money. Nicole Smith, she said exactly, I don't care who got the most money, me or him. You do me wrong once, I'm going to get my lick back and get the hell on. Forever getting that lick back. Forever getting your lick back. Okay, Michael G. Body. Guys use money to manipulate and control women because they are weak, trying to hide their weakness. He doesn't have self-control, so he seeks satisfaction, trying to control others because he lacks control and respect within himself. That is true. A lot of men who got the money, again, that's what I'm saying. You just won in a million, Michael. And we're going to say shout out to Michael G. Body. You know, shout out to you. You won in a million. You probably won in a billion. I don't know. But Stephon, I got the production man here. We're going to hear from him. What you prefer to date? You prefer to date a woman with less than you or more than you?
To me, her money is irrelevant.
So, ain't no price on your faithfulness like you just asked me?
I would rather her have more money than me.
You would rather have more money than you? Why?
It's more money for the team.
But why you want to have more money than you?
Because I'm going to do what I got to do to get as much money as I can.
Okay.
If she got more money than me, that's just a plus.
Great.
I'm still going to pay all the bills anyway.
Hello. I don't care how much money I got in my bank account, you're going to pay them bills.
Her money.
You going to pay them bills. I don't care how much money I got in my bank account, you're going to pay them bills. So that was that's what I wanted to. It's a lot of people going to eat me up about this. Frankly, I don't care. Key Reed, money is needed, but it's not the foundation of a relationship. True. Key Reed, a lot of people get it misconstrued. A lot of men like to come into a relationship with finances, thinking that they need the finances to get a woman. Real women don't care about if you got it or not. We're trying to build together. We're trying to build together. A woman will have 10,000 in her account to say she broke. Key Kendrick, you know something. You know something. You know something. So, I want y'all to keep going in on these comments because I can see it, but we're going to go ahead on and get into a quick video. I want to introduce this video. It's one of my videos. It's my very own video. You know, shout out to me. You know, I made this video. Did the streets. You know, a lot of people probably haven't seen the video. A lot of y'all did. But before we go, hold on, Stephon. Let's read Quan Boston comment. It doesn't matter, irrelevant. At the end of the day, if we are a team, that's what it is. Okay, so I guess you 2 out of 1 million. You know, women still overrule. Women still overrule, and it still ain't gonna change. All the woman in here is saying a man rather date a woman that has less money than him because he like to control and manipulate the woman with money. So we're going to go ahead on again to my video, Ditter Streets. I want you guys to go subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you not already did, I want you to go ahead and follow me on Instagram at Griselda B. I want you to go follow Strong Arm Radio at Strong Arm Radio and go follow at the Griselda B Show. I know I ask y'all to do a lot, but I want y'all to go ahead and do it anyway to keep up with exclusive interviews and behind the scenes. So check out my new video, Ditter Streets by me, Griselda B. Shout out to y'all. We are keeping it live, locked on Strong Arm Radio, and we will be right back.
Bitches like me, you hoes gon' talk, but you hoes won't fight me. All you hoes broke, soft and it's sad. And you hatin' on me cause I'm really in my bag. Real talk, I don't fuck with you bitches cause you real flop. Through a crowd full of haters, I'ma still
big
walk
stample.
Cause you hoes don't scare me, try it and I put it on your mammy. Ho, I'm doing me, you doing you, we ain't the same. Hoes bring my name up just to get some fame. Clout chasing hoes on the net, sending threats. I'm out everywhere and I ain't get touched yet. Fame hoes talking when they see me, bitches freeze. The Harlem shaking like damn 5 degrees. If I had a dick, I'd have you hoes on your knees. And I ain't even begging when I tell you bitches, please. You bitches better chill. I'm a local rapper living like I got a deal. Been around the world, damn, I drove every Benz. As long as I'm getting money, I don't ever need a friend. Speaking on a friend, tell that hoe I said fuck her. Low key hating and I really couldn't trust her. Started moving flake, telling bitches my business. And jumped in my inbox trying to beg me for forgiveness. Fuck you, hoe. And I don't beef about no dick. Give a fuck about these niggas, including the one I'm with. Life too lit and I'm really getting rich. To sum it all up, and these niggas ain't shit.
You ain't shit.
GB this and GB that. When you mention me, tell these hoes GB back. And I got something to prove, so I'm coming with a vengeance. You rap hoes better pay attention. Bitch, I been a truth and I'm always been facts. And I made a living running in and out of sex. Then I flipped that, focused on my mission. Tripled my bag up, then dropped my own business, ho. Come and get body, bitch, and I ain't talking sugar walls. If I pull it off the hip, I'ma knock you out your draw. Self-made hood star, bitch, I made myself a boss. Commas and assets is how I floss. And I never took a loss, all my L's was a lesson. To be in my possession, baby boy, I am a blessing. Good in my skin, hell nah, I ain't stressing. Surrounded by gangsters, real niggas in my section. On drink, GB this and GB that. When you mention me, tell these hoes GB back. And I got something to prove, so I'm coming with a vengeance. You rap hoes better pay attention.
Pay attention.
GB this and GB that. When you mention me, tell these hoes GB back. And I got something to prove, so I'm coming with a vengeance. You rap hoes better pay attention.
Pay attention.
Pay attention. Pay attention. Pay attention.
Yeah, just like that. I am back, right? How y'all feeling my video? Do y'all like it? It's my not key with the fire. Yes, that's my video. That's my latest video. Ditter Streets. Y'all can go ahead and always check out my YouTube channel at Griselda B on YouTube. And I did that video. I just want to let y'all know, like, it was a dedication to my sister. Y'all seen at the end, I represent my baby wherever I go. Long live Dreek. Like, shout out to Dreek. That's my heart. I represent her everywhere I go.
Dreek.
I wear her chain everywhere I go. You know, that was one of the hardest videos back in October. You know, I love y'all from tuning in. If y'all not already did it, I want y'all to go ahead and share this live. Tell a friend to tune in with us. We are live tonight on the Griselda B Show. And guess what they got for me? Y'all already know, every Tuesday night, it's a Bel-Air night. Every Tuesday night, it's a Bel-Air night here at the Griselda B Show. Shout out to Telly Dredd, Dre Napple, and Oso.
Okay.
They make it come, they laugh off the island. They make it do what it do for your girl. So y'all liked that video. Oh, Monique Pickens, hey, from Dallas, Texas. Shout out to you, baby. Quan Boston. I love it. She's smiling down on you. Quan Boston. My baby with me every step of the way. I have one wish. Y'all already know what it is. But we live on the Griselda B Show. We got one of the biggest bosses coming in tonight, Frank Castle. Y'all open this up. He will be tuned in with us tonight, y'all. If y'all have not done it, I can't stress it enough. Go follow the Strong Arm Radio on Instagram. The Griselda B Show on Instagram. Griselda B on Instagram. Keep it locked. Ooh, that's the sound. That's the sound of the Bel Air tonight. So we're going to be moving along. Bettina Washington from Birmingham, Alabama. Hey, baby, what's going on? Hey, what's going on? Y'all is really tuned in tonight. I love the energy. I love everybody that's on this show. And it's a lot of y'all haven't shared the show because they don't have share at the top. If you will, I'm asking, could you go ahead and just share this live so more people can tune in with us. Duval County, Kimberly Wilson, shout out to you. Oh, Nicole Broughton from Mississippi. What part of Mississippi are you from? Jackson, Mississippi? We have Kamari Thompson from San Francisco, California in the building. Amanda from Tuskegee, Alabama. We got Washington, D.C. We got B. James from Virginia. We got Tamika Potter. Hey, cousin from Savannah. We got Brianna Reynolds from Valdosta, Georgia. Y'all keep it coming. Go ahead and drop it and let me know where y'all from. Y'all all the way tuned in with me from Miami 305. I got Michael Ravens fan from Hawaii. Hola. Hola. Red Everage from Dallas. Oh, I got somebody from Biloxi. Oh, my God. We tuned in tonight. We got Philadelphia. We got Baton Rouge. South Carolina. T-Rex from Miami. What they do, T-Rex? Shout out to you and Keita. Congratulations on baby Aiden. I'm so proud. I'm so happy for y'all. Like, oh my God, I love y'all forever. Oh my God. Look at, he wrote back from Hawaii. He say, mahala. We got Athens, Georgia. Oh, y'all showing Griselda be so much love tonight. It, only if y'all could share this live like y'all comment this live. Tonight will be such a beautiful night. And I have one of those cups. Greensboro, North Carolina, Thomasville, Georgia, Erico 22947, Orlando. Oh, yeah. Tonight we tuned in. Can y'all share this live? We got Robin Hood. What up? Detroit. Tell us, you didn't even take the thing off the
line. I did.
We tuned in. We got it locked on the Strong Arm Radio. 813 here. Yeah, Daytona in the building. Tacoma, Washington. So this live broadcast isn't sponsored, you know, what us by I Crave, you know. If y'all want to go ahead and get some of the great soul food out of Miami, you guys could hit up I Crave. It got great meals, quality meals, good feeling soul food for the soul. You know, you want to get catering services.
Grandma Bobby.
You go ahead and eat it. You see them smothered pork chops? That's what I'm talking about. Y'all hit up I Crave for that good soul food in the heart of Liberty City on 47th Street and 7th Avenue. Shout out to I Crave. You know, got everything looking good and keeping everybody fed.
That's a Dark and Lovely right there.
They got the Dark and Lovely on the menu. That fried chicken right there with the yams, collard greens, and mac and cheese is called the Dark and Lovely. I ate just about everything on I Crave menu. You know, they got great food. You can check out their social media page at I Crave on IG. You know, go tell them Griselda B sent you to try some of that good soul food coming out of Miami. Polk County, my sister Latoya Boswell. Shout out to you, baby. What's happening? And of course, I want to give Jamel a shout out. Y'all see, he got the girl looking good tonight. Y'all feeling it? Jamel on the install. Yeah. Jamel got me looking good. You know what I'm saying? Stephon got the cameras, the production. Yeah, tonight is a very, very, very great night. Tonight is the night. Shout out to you, Jamel. Yes, I Crave is located on 46th and 7th Avenue. Okay, Misty. We talk about I Crave and she dropping about a driver's license repair, but it's all good. I guess you feel like the people tuned in, you want to advertise, but it's the fee for that, baby.
Make sure she shared.
You make sure you go ahead and share this live since you're doing free advertisement, but it's all good and it's all love. Michael Ravens fans say love the stripping grits and the ox-telling grits, that was like, you know, when I first ate I Crave and I looked at the menu and it said grits and oxtails, I'm like, what kind of it is this? Grits and oxtails, like, that don't even match. But when I taste it, I was like, yeah, this it right here. This it. Shout out to I Crave. Like, I never ate oxtails and grits before. But when I taste they oxtails and grits, it was good. But you know, everybody know I'm a pasta type of girl. I definitely love their spaghetti every Tuesday. I Crave got the best spaghetti with the good sweet corn and the soft garlic bread.
With the pepperoni.
Like, with the pepperoni and the spaghetti, if you don't want pepperoni, it's all good too. But I Crave got the best spaghetti. And oh yeah, there go my hairstylist. Y'all be sure to follow him, Jamel Flannery. Oh, he ain't no kin to Big Meech to me, though. Right, you ain't from the D. He ain't none of the BMF brothers with the last name. But Jamel, you see how you got your girl looking all, yeah. Hair on Jamel, whatever is giving. What is hair giving? Yeah. That's it. Yeah, Michael saying it was banging. Grits and oxtails, definitely it. Yes, I Crave, you know, I'm a spaghetti fan. Everybody in the world know, if you ever want to feed me, bring me some spaghetti. So yeah, I Crave got the best spaghetti every Tuesday. If y'all have not tried I Crave, go ahead and try I Crave. There go their social media right there. You can go ahead and hit the follow button. Check out their menu on there. You know, they have a lot of celebrities stop by. The food is awesome. The food is great. Shout out to Eric and Chi Chi Van Dyke. You know, they holding it down. You know, we got to big up entrepreneurs coming from the, you know, from the hood, from the bottom, and making nothing into something. I Crave is definitely on the menu. If you coming down to visit Miami, you can always stop by I Crave for the great soul food. T-Dot, I love y'all too in Oklahoma. Everybody that's on this live, y'all know I'm going to say it 1,000 times and more. Shout out to Missy Baptiste. I see she went and shared it because it got share at the top. Thank you. Sean Town and YoGB, you need to start back rapping. They feeling you in here where I'm at. I had to let... Go ahead, move the comment. Yeah. Wait. They feeling you where I'm in here, where I'm at. I had to let them know you here representing. You already know. Everybody already know what I live by. Everybody know what I bleed. I'm from Overtown, Miami. Overtown, town for life. You know, you can take the girl from the hood. You just can't take the hood out of the girl. You know, I'm Overtown. I die for Overtown. Town for life. Shout out to everybody from Overtown. You know, we holding it down. We all like family over there. I want to trade over town for nothing in the world. So shout out to you, Shane or Sean Towner. You know, we holding it down. Towner for life. And I need you to go ahead and share this video too, Shane Towner. Let everybody know that the Griselda B Show is live. And everybody tuning in, I'm loving the energy. Everything is beautiful. Everything is good. Okay, okay. Y'all see them Over Town girls on there. TPV Nisha, Town for Life. She out of the projects with me. Town Paul, where they coming from. Cherie Ella B, Town for Life. She Swamp City. All that. Yeah, Over Town is the place to be. If you didn't know, we that. I want to trade Over Town for the real, no matter how far I go. I'm going to always come back Over Town and go to Cotton's to get the best kunk and fries. I drive 40 minutes from where I'm at to Over Town to get the kunk and fries. Trust it, I would never, ever, ever take the hood out of me. Preston York. Yeah, shout out to y'all. Michael Ravenfest said, girl, you hood good, and that's on the real. Shout out to everybody that show love. Y'all already know, 1900 second quack. For sure. Yeah, see, this Over Town. You know, some people here from the city, they ain't really feeling us, but you know, they gotta go ahead and smell us. They gotta go ahead and smell us. Over Town, Ben took over. Everybody came to Miami wanted to go through Over Town. They wanted to know what Over Town was like. Mm-hmm. Go ahead. So we want to get back on the question now that everybody is tuned in. Do you think men prefer to date a woman with more money than him or less money than him? Cherie Ellaby, Committee 2000, baby. I'm with you. I'm with you, Cherie. But I see you, Cherie. You ain't sharing this live because it don't have share at the top. I need you to go ahead and share this live. Okay, y'all, we here. 19 and 3rd, why that's so bad. Okay, so yeah, we tuned in tonight. Everybody, Missy Baptiste said, my dude said, "Bae, I'm glad you made way more than me." T dot, money takes away their power for sure. That's what I'm saying. Now that we have men in here, I want Dre Knapp to get in here. Sit in this chair right here. And I want you to chime in on this topic. No, it's two. I want you to chime right there. You gotta put all that down. I'm a business owner and I grind to get my bags. It's all about the island on 56. Okay. Damn. Where, babe? Okay, so now that we have a man in here, and we got him chimed in. So tell me how you feel. Do you think that a man would prefer to date a woman that has more money than him or less money than him?
Shit. Me, I did a... Girl, she got less money than me or more money than me. He ain't got no.
But how that make you feel as a man if your woman got way more money than you?
Shit.
You can't control her. You can't tell her what to do.
Nah, but it made me want to, I got to grind hard. You feel me? I got to go get the bread like her. But I ain't finna be just sitting around just letting her do everything. Though. You gotta get
so something. Even though she got more money than you, you still going to pay all the bills?
Yeah. I mean, nigga going to... They gonna pay some bills, yeah.
You said some. Y'all be sure not to date him. He paying some of the bills.
Right.
Some? I'm gonna pay them. No, you got to pay all. Yeah. Capital A, capital L, capital L. So you rather date a woman that has less than you or more than you? Or you want her to match your hustle?
Shit, more than me. She gonna match my husband anyways.
Oh my god!
I'm sleep all day. I be up early. She gonna be mad at me. She gonna want me to go to sleep.
You can't control her, and if you have more money, then she can't control you. See, the thing is, people use the money as control.
She be young.
Hey.
Talk about 60-40.
We 60-40 right here. Baby, I don't know about we 60-40. Shout out to Skull Boy, baby, because we looking more like 80-20 on my side.
Don't even try my man's like
that's
that.
That's my guy. everybody know he my guy, but I know he gonna handle up. Like,
yeah,
yeah, he gonna handle up. So I, you know, I'm just kicking it. You know what I'm saying? Me personally, I like to break even. Man. I like to break even because when you break even, that means you could go and I could go and both of us still gonna be good. So I don't want to date a man that have more than me, because a man who really have more than a woman, in my opinion, he gonna treat her like shit.
Why you feel that
negative?
Why do you feel that way?
It's been done a lot.
No, why would you feel that way?
Because look, if the female, say for instance, the man moving with the female, right?
No.
That's what I'm telling you. You feel what I'm saying? Well, you can't even get the stuff and go. Damn, like, we got disagreement, but you ready to kick me out? Because you got a house.
But you just said out your mouth you'd rather her to have more than you. So if she got more than you, you definitely getting kicked out then.
Why would you feel that way?
One thing about it.
So you got more than the person you would
kick
about?
Look at Shantiqua. You see, you starting off wrong already, because that's what I'm saying.
So you would kick him out?
Yes.
I ain't going to kick nobody out.
She look at my sister. She know.
Pretty legs, ego. They feel like the shit with more. Yeah, they feel like that shit. Oh, God, had those scuds on my waist. Something happened.
Yeah, buddy, you 80-20 over there, my boy.
He was already watching the live. He just clicked on and made himself be known. He was sitting back watching it already, because how he jump on soon when I say his name? Nobody ain't tag him.
Now that man don't be watching. He be scrolling.
Okay. So do you prefer to date a woman that has more money than you or less money than you?
So what about y'all?
It don't matter.
Would you prefer?
I just told you about me. I prefer to date someone who can match my hustle, or I can match his hustle. I done been in a situation before where I dated someone who had more than me, and they treated me like shit. And in my mind, the whole time,
so
I was saying,
"Any man gonna do that?"
I don't know. I just gotta protect me.
That's the point.
I gotta protect me.
Females do that too.
Do what?
Treat a man like shit
when they got it.
I don't know about that. Nah, some men probably already ain't shit, and then they just happen to get treated like what they are. Like, I don't know. I'm finna ask Stephon, is that right? But then I looked and realized he's a man. So, so yeah, you know, we home.
I know one thing I won't do. I would never move in to her place. And I ain't got my name on it. That would never.
Why?
I don't care
why,
if it's open.
Why
I done got kicked
why
out.
Why you want?
The place was in my name and I still got kicked out. Well, I did that too, but it's a different kind of respect. It's a different kind of respect.
So while everybody chiming in on the topic,
please share.
I want you guys to go ahead and share it. And I also want, if y'all have any businesses or brand that you guys want me to promote and advertise on the show, you could go ahead and inbox me. You can get in my DM on Instagram. However you prefer, you can contact the Griselda B Show at Instagram and let us know, you know, what is it that you want us to promote, and we'll go ahead and make it happen for you. So if you have not already shared the live, I want you to go ahead and share the live. I want you to follow Strong Arm Radio on Instagram. I want you to follow the Griselda B Show on Instagram. And I want you to follow me, Griselda B, the one with the big mouth, on Instagram. You know, for all exclusive interviews and updates about the artists that be on the show and all the behind the scenes, y'all could follow all of that on the Griselda B Show Instagram page. Okay, Laquanza Allen, it depends on the man. I need you to match my hustle.
Look at this one.
Shantiqua, the problem is it's a struggle on a single man out here. They ass always got an excuse as to why they are and where they supposed to be. Shantiqua, I'm with you when you're right. Every time you meet a man and he ain't up the pot, he always talk about how his last girlfriend done dogged him out, and so she took everything he had, and
so,
you know, it was just a whole mess with him. It's like every time you know, like when you see a guy, wherever you meet a man, he look like everything good with him. But when you really get to know him, he got so many problems.
So what about the female? Like, what about the female?
He got many problems.
What about the woman?
Hey, Missy, we done gave you a chance to advertise. Like, you muttony now, sister. We love you, but you definitely muttony, sis. Go ahead and pay for advertisement. All you got to do is inbox me, and you pay for your advertisement, and we can make it happen on the show. You don't have to do all that. We make you a whole video, a whole slide. All I'm saying is, if you want to be advertised on the Griselda B Show, you need to inbox me and send me, and we'll get right back at you. Free promotion on this page, that ain't gonna happen, because it will get you blocked. And I got number love for you, but the block game is strong.
I'm saying though, so that so female don't.
Okay, Rude Brown say I'm that kind of girl that that go 50-50.
I'm with main man right here.
Women have those problems as well.
Okay,
Michael.
Man. Okay.
What problems women have? Women have the problem because when a man get with that woman, he becomes the problem. Cause you don't be coming with nothing but a bag of clothes.
So that's it.
That's you know, all you come with.
You know, a hurt person hurt people.
Yeah.
So what if the girl already hurt?
But what if you hurt? Why you hurt?
Wow.
What if you hurt?
When
you
hurt, I'm
first
happy.
Of all, let's be clear. Like we go, I don't even want this to come all the way into a different subject, but let's be clear. Most of the time when you guys moving in with a woman, y'all already coming with nothing but what's in your boxes for number one.
Oh,
you ain't got
God.
Nothing. So you're going to try to do good on the come out, and you're going to end up spending the night, and then you never leave. So now she done took on the whole problem over a one-night stand. Let's be clear. You want to go there.
You know what she was giving.
You already this, said you gonna pay some of the bills and not all, so that already was a red flag.
Dang.
I'm just saying though.
Don't forget 30 baby mamas too, who all bitter. I wonder why. This well said. Oh, Michael say women can't pay their own bills, they have bad credit. A lot of men have bad credit.
Oh, so no woman don't?
Okay, you see, respect Gigi say y'all coming with nothing but weed. I'm with you, sister. I'm with you.
What?
Missy got
what's
red
from. What's she from?
What's she
from? She gotta be from out of up north.
Look, Crystal Beasley say all bitter baby mamas. All bitter baby mamas.
I don't care if you got the bigger bag or I got the bigger bag. We gonna run it up together.
Yes. There's some knucklehead females out here. I'm telling you. Men ain't, man.
I got straight females in my family, I know. Nobody can't tell me about no female, bro. Nobody can't tell me about
But that's still, you ain't telling us about you. Man, GB speaking to the ass, okay, come with the problems, period.
That's a problem right now.
Okay, who was Anthony? And women comes with fakeness because she say she never or she don't, but men get hurt because of women. What men get hurt because of women?
You see what Skull Bud said?
No, what he said?
GB, how you gonna say that both of us was broke and forgot?
Okay then.
Okay, listen.
Okay then.
Listen what Skull said. Skull said, GB. Okay, Skull Bud said, GB, how you gonna... Go back down so we can read his comment. Let's address it to the people. He said, GB, how you gonna say that? Both of us was broke, you forgot? Both of us was broke. And when we was broke, we had the best love. And I'm going to be honest. When me and Bud was broke, when I first got with him, he wasn't where he wanted to be. And I wasn't where I wanted to be. We both was broke. But we had real love. When he got rich and I got rich, the cables got tangled up. Because it's like, you can't tell me what to do and I can't tell you what to do. So if I had to give anything back in my relationship, I'd take the broke Bud. And he'll prefer the broke GB because we had real love. We was on one mission, one accord. We was grinding to get that bag. You know how rich people don't respect people.
Right.
Rich people don't respect people. And don't get it twisted. Ain't nobody boasting. Ain't nobody bragging. But when you in a different type of bracket, it like y'all can ask Bud, he on his live. He really can't tell me what to do. And I can't tell him what to do. We nut all the time. But it's real love. You get what I'm saying? It's real love. Like, he not the type of dude that want to control. But he could tell me what to do. Yeah, I'm not going to say he can't. So I'm gonna recant that.
Rephrase that.
Yeah, I'm gonna rephrase and recant to whatever.
He can
tell me what to do. But I'm saying, like, far as money-wise, like, we good. Like, ain't nobody tripping. We good, but, you know... We met each other broke, so we met each other. One was rich and the other one was rich. So most of y'all dudes coming in, y'all coming with nothing. Wow. Y'all be hoping y'all take her home from the club to spend a night. Y'all don't be having nowhere to go anyway.
And she be hoping the same thing. She be hoping she take that nigga home.
He say, so how you gonna say a man want more than his girl? Duh.
Cause you wanna be the man.
Listen, all men got a problem with their woman having more money than them. Let's just be clear.
Hey, no, not really. Not
Listen,
really.
Keep talking about two nutcases. That ain't P. I'll wait you, Misty. They don't come with nothing but a black garbage bag. And that's if you got a dude that's top of the line. Because some of them coming with what they had on, they going to wear that for 3 days. He's scared if you ask him to leave, you ain't going to open the door tomorrow. So he's going to chill for 3 days.
Yeah, he's top of the line. You
got to
go.
And it is what it is.
I've been watching too much Cynthia G.
Okay, shout out to Jig. He said, when you struggling, that shows how thorough a person can be.
Okay, then. Listen. How I feel about this situation?
How you feel?
Real talk. Like, if she got more than me, all right, a nigga still down. Hold a nigga down till a nigga get where a nigga supposed to be. I don't shit on no nigga now, you feel me? That's if I got more than her, that's how a nigga supposed to play it, you feel me? But like you say, when you got the money, you gonna do what you wanna do. You wanna say what
but
you wanna do.
But it's some females, bro. If a nigga got bread, someone will be having that hustle on, you feel me?
No, because a lot of us females, I'm gonna be real. A lot of us females.
You gotta find a one for the struggle with.
Wait. Look at Bud on here capping. Why Bud on here talking about I moved in his space?
Alright.
Okay, wait, hold on. Let me send you this, Stephon.
Okay.
We can go ahead and take this commercial break in a second. I want you to play. It's. Let me know when you're ready. Let's read these comments.
I'm just saying, you're supposed to stay down with your nigga no matter what.
That's how I look at it.
We both eat.
Misty, I'm with you. I swear, they be looking so good on the outside. But let me tell you, the Cuban be fake. What is Bud talking about? I moved in his spot. Bud, that's a whole different era. I put money in on that spot. Goodbye. You got it?
Mr. Wall.
She said narcissists niggas be from the bottom, baby. For real, they do. Some of y'all mess it up for females though. Especially the ones who work hard. King J, how you figure that?
We about to boot Missy off.
Missy, they want to block you off because you telling the truth.
No, she ain't telling. She lying, man.
Shout out to you, Toya Boswell. You see Bud all over Toya. She put GB done hit a nerve. Bud all over. Bud all over it. Like, I don't understand. Bud, no. And I'm going to be honest with y'all. Bud got way more money than me. But he ain't gonna look girl at me. I don't care how much money he got, because all that money he got, that's my money.
So what the fuck?
I tell him how to spend it.
What the hell? Hold on. What?
And I get mad when he spend his own money.
So what?
Oh, that's for the camera.
No, it's not. It's true. He got way more money than me. He do. But I get mad when he spend his money. Especially if it ain't on me. Can y'all get on this live and tell Bud to give me a new Birkin bag? Because I've been waiting since Valentine's Day.
No.
Hopefully if y'all get on here and tag Birkin all the way down, I could get one at least for Mother's Day.
Bud, swiped up and exit out of here.
Y'all tag Bud and put Birkin. At Bud Birkin. Please, hopefully I can get one for, I can get one for Mother's Day. You ready, Stephon? So we're going to take a quick video break. I'll be back with you guys. Keep it locked on Scrum On Radio. We will be back in a minute.
God, what a hell of a feeling. Different meeting with them bosses, talking liquidation. Smoking out the turkey, every spliff amazing. First nigga out the city to touch Hov hands. Different stresses turn to blessings, I'm like, oh man. Los and Lafi with me when I'm bouncing through. All them foreigns parked outside the fountain blue. Champagne shots with Mel and Big Klee. The mob with me, feeling like I'm Big Meech. I'm stunting with all these cables on me. Dodging calls, I'm knowing that all these labels want me. Top models be leaving all of their makeup on me. Niggas was sleep, I made them wake up on me. Now they screaming bleep, yeah it's Big Bleep. Buck done double up, yeah that boy a beast. Shang on rock and roll if I'm right or wrong. 3-piece stacks while we in the zone. I learned to give my niggas they flowers while they in, you heard me? Odaw, what's up? Breeze, what's good, nigga? Yeah, ski, feel. We had to learn that discipline, but we got that shipment in. I would work that 10 to 10, and Los would work that 10 to 10. Yeah, we ran that 24, bitch, we had to get it in. Started from that bucket, then we moved up to that tenant bin. Used to ride that Lumina, knew we had to tune it up. But we would keep the foreigns, how we going, we gon' boom it up. Did all that trapping, just investing in the rapping, so at this point, we gotta make this shit happen. I'ma give it all my all, ain't no capping, ain't no acting. Moonwalking in these Bendies, Billie Jean, Michael Jackson. I get hustler of the year, but hell, I'm still a father first. All my queens don't want a thing, rest up king, that's all it's worth. They say I went Hollywood, the real, no, it's not true. Niggas did switch, and so did the Glock too. Running up this money just to ease the pain. And I rock a COVID mask so we don't breathe the same. I'm gone. Yeah. B-Thug, roll one, nigga. Hey, Ted, you might be in Georgia, but you're with me. You get me? Big love.
Y'all already know what it is. The Big Z in the building. I told y'all he was coming. He is here. He is tuned in.
All the way in.
Let him know what's going on.
What's up? What's up? What's up? We in the biddy.
Shout out to Frank Castle. He is here in the
building.
Shout out
to Griselda Show. You know, shout out to this good thing, man. New ventures. New, you know, I like this.
We played your video. You had everybody putting a fire on there.
Appreciate that.
Everybody throwing the Haiti flags on
appreciate that.
Oh, my God. They want to know who the biggest Z is. We finally got Frank Castle here in the video.
26 in here. Talk to me.
Oh, God. I don't know. If I'm feeling like I'm a... you know how you get starstruck a
little. Nah, you the star.
I'm starstruck a little bit. You don't know if it's the Bel-Air or is that, you know.
It's your show. You
we
the
got
star.
The biggest in the building.
You the star, man. It's your show.
So, Frank, talk to these people, Castle. Let them know. They want to know about you. They got the comments going. I want everybody to put shout out Frank Castle. You know.
Castle with a K, baby.
Yeah, Castle with a K. It's FrankKastle 13.
I had the 13.
Yes, that's him on Facebook. I want y'all to go take a second, and I want y'all to go ahead and follow his page on Instagram, on Facebook. Keep it locked. Like I told y'all, he one of the biggest coming out of Miami. I told y'all he got his own style. He got his own wave. I told you he give like that luxury, you know, boss feeling on his. Okay, okay. We got people talking about Frank Castle. We got shout out to Bree Buckethead. Does say 26er.
Okay, okay, Bree, what they do?
Okay, we see y'all. Okay.
Okay, okay.
We want everybody to go ahead and put Frank Castle 13 in the comments. Hashtag him, go follow his page. Okay.
Drug free.
Missy Baptiste said Frank Castle with the castle.
With a K, baby.
No, she put the actual castle like you king, baby.
Okay.
Okay, okay. So we're going to go ahead on and get into a couple of questions on we want to interview.
Star, how you doing though?
No. We're going to get into that. It ain't about me. This ain't about me. This about you. You know, but I'm doing good though. You know, I see you, like I just told these people earlier, your grind is unmatched. Like, you everywhere, you promoting everywhere, yeah. You doing everything. Yeah, you know, you vibing. Like, you there.
You gotta chase it. You chasing the dream. You gotta chase that journey. Gotta keep going. Can't stop. Gotta keep going till you get to that destination where you feel like you don't stop, but you still keep going. Till you get to another destination, man. And it's a long journey, you know. Don't let nobody stop you from it.
Yeah.
Dream, goals,
And you always get
not
like
all my bad bitches, misses, hit the flow.
And that's
the you got a bad, credit, good, hit the flow.
Sure.
It's your body.
She pop champagne and smoke more. Push it and shake that ass like, oh yeah, you know. Now all my bad bitches, misses, hit the flow. You got a bag, let it good, hit the flow. It's your birthday, pop champagne and sip some more. It's your birthday, shake that ass like a pro. Oh yeah, you know, let me hit it on your dress up. Let me fuck up all your makeup. Pussy in my cup and let me sip it till you shake up. Make our way to the laundry room, air out dirty laundry, ooh. Wearing see-through things, I can't see no panties, ooh. Turn your camera filter on, always by the beat on. Once you hear they turn it on, screaming like it's your soul. You smell good, rolling up my backwoods. I just wanna chill, baby, catch a little vibe. Run your climax high, legs to the sky. Love on dance, slow you twist and turn while I stroke your stroke. Put it on me like you back it up, ready, set, and go. Let me fix your hair, hold and ride me like a rodeo.
I ain't even jumping
into
that, but I gotta tell you too, because I remember one time he was on social media. Oh, they saying they can't hear. I don't know what that shit in my cup.
Let all my bad bitches, misses, hit the flow. Hit the flow. You got a bad credit, good, hit the flow. They pop champagne, sip some more. They shake that ass like a pro. Oh yeah, you know. Now all my bad bitches, misses, hit the flow. You got a bad credit, good, hit the flow. It's your birthday, pop champagne and sip some more.
It's your birthday.
They shake that ass like a pro. Oh yeah, you know. Reaching for the stars, climax what we reaching. You know what it is, girl. Ain't no speaking low. Gotta live your life. How I feel about you, can't disguise. Throw your.
I mean, it's a nice setup, man. You know, being cool. Anytime I walk in the room, it's just that feeling.
Is you a boss?
Who said that?
Me.
You know, I'm not a boss.
What a hell of a feeling.
I'm a go getter. You
know
what I'm saying?
No, he just talks so low.
I'm not a boss.
The hood
keeps sweat. You know, I'm a type of nigga to show everybody it could be done. You know what I'm saying? You could be a bum today and a rich nigga tomorrow. Mm. You know what I'm saying? You could be a whore today and bad as bitch tomorrow. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just, I won't put no title on being a boss. That boss shit is just a title. You know what I'm saying? But people be, you know, you want to be a boss, but the question is you ready to become a boss? You know what I'm saying? There's a lot that come with titles and shit. The title, but some titles be too big for the person that title themselves that shit. You know what I'm saying? That's why I can't call myself a king, because you know a king gotta have a village, and a village, he gotta be the one that put that village together. You got, there's some kings out there. I'm not gonna say no king out there. Some kings out there, you know what I'm saying? But when we're in a journey to become a king, can't, you know what I'm saying? You can't be quick to put that title on you.
Okay, so now I want to ask you, like I always want to know. Mm-hmm. How did you get that name, Frank Castle?
Oh, you know, back in the days, you know, I was young, you know, I was always out on the streets with the older guys and stuff like that. They used to take me to freak beats and stuff like that, you know, and I was young for the girls, grabbing the girls' ass and shit. So one of the old OGs named Redeemer, you know, he used to see how I run to the girls, and if a guy come and try to approach, you know, I'd be ready to fight and shit like that. He'd be like, damn boy, you be ready to punish them niggas and shit. And everybody used to rap back then. So he was like, you know what, I'm gonna call you Frank Castle, man. I'm like, who the hell is a Frank Castle? And he was like, man, you know Frank Castle, man, I'm gonna call you Frank Castle. So later in life, he never told me who Frank Castle was. Later in life, when I was in school and shit, calling myself Frank Castle, and come to understand that Frank Castle was a goddamn punisher. So I'm like, damn, man, what the fuck? And then find out he was a cop, all type of shit. I was like, man, you know what? I'm gonna keep that Frank Castle, but I'm gonna change that C to a K. You feel me? Frank Castle. And then when, you know, when I got jammed up and shit, you know, they called me the 26 and the 13, 26. 13-6, you feel what I'm saying? So I had a 13 just to make it significant to the Frank Castle 13. So they know the 13 being, you know, I'm a Z. So you feel me? So that's how it came about.
And what is a Z? For us don't know. Is Z mean a Zo?
A Z short term for Zo. A Z short term for the mafia. You feel me? A Z short term for Zos right now. We ain't saying Zo. We saying, what's up, Z?
Okay. So yeah, that's the Z. I thought the Z.
Put out the Z. Z is
the 26th letter of the alphabet. Oh, do the Z phone.
All right. That right way. They know how the Z go. You know what I'm saying? You know, shout out to all my Z's out there. You feel me? They're watching the live. I shared this live, so there's a lot of them online right now watching it.
Okay, shout out to all the Z's out there.
Chain gang, you know, they in the chain gang laying down.
Respect, Gigi says Zo. Okay, we didn't know. So we want to ask you, like, what made you get into rapping? Because I've known you back in the days before you was rapping. You was on some whole different type of, I just never seen you turning into becoming this positive or, you know, like, just like being out in the forefront. You was always kind of like reserved, like behind the scenes.
Yeah, you know, before you come out to be present, you got to reserve yourself, you get what I'm saying? So the rapping always been there. It's just that, you know, it leaped. I never leaped to go ahead and push forward to it, you get what I'm saying? So when once I grasped and felt comfortable in coming out rapping and stuff like that, I say, man, fuck it, cause you know rapping. I started rapping in fourth grade, you know, and I can remember rest in peace, Uncle Al, coming to the schoolhouse and on career day, asking everybody what they want to be. My first thing was the rapper. You know what I'm saying? He was like, damn, you want to be a rapper. Everybody saying police officer. So I was so infatuated with the rap. You know, I used to sit down. My brothers them used to rap around the house every day. I used to be sitting in front of the jukebox watching music videos, watching the girls, watching the niggas with the big chains. And we'd be
with the long chains.
With the long chains and be infatuated with that shit. So I was like, man, this is what a nigga want to do when I didn't get up, man. Fuck all that shit. I want to be a rapper. So when you knew me, when we met, it was just like, you know, a toll to pause. I had to choose between the street and being doing this music shit. And you had to understand, long run, that the street cannot match if you're doing this music shit. So I was doing the street shit, you feel me, and doing the music, but you see more of the street shit.
Yeah, you know what I saying? Did. Because he was on a whole different level. Okay, so, like, even when you said that you was in front of the jukebox and you seen all your brothers rapping, yeah. Who inspired you to make music?
I'm gonna have to say my fourth grade teacher. No, not my fourth grade teacher, my seventh grade teacher, Mr. Ramirez. You know, I used to lose rap books all the time. And he took my rap books. And one day I walked into class, and this dude was like, you know, you have my rap book. And I'm like, what the hell? Like, yeah, you know, I went and proofread your rap book. I'm like, what the fuck? He's like, yeah, man, you always talking in my classroom. Nigga, I went to go read your rap book. So he took my rap book, you know, he scratched out a lot of words out of that shit and shit. So, you know, he was telling me, man, yeah, you should be a writer, man. I like the fact that you take your time and write all these things in there, man. That be going through your head and everything like that, man. From that day right there, he put me in his debating class. And I was like, man, shit, we finna go full throttle with this shit, man.
So what's your creating process like? Man. When you create and make your song, what do you do? Like, you know, for me, when I was into music and doing rap, I would literally have to get in the shower. That's where I make my best music. I don't know. It's kind of weird. But when I'm in the shower and it's just something like, you know, when you're in the shower and you taking your shower, you singing some song. Like, you know, so you singing. So, but when I would get in the shower, I would create. I'd just be trying to freestyle, and I really don't know how to freestyle good. So I was just freestyling for you. Know, I'm like, oh shit, that shit sound live.
I'm so loud. It really just be flowing. I could be just outside singing, can you stop the rain? And then a beat to come on, and you know, the rap come on. Anywhere I'm at, man, it just comes to me right there, and I just write it down. You know, quick second, write it down real quick. Hold it down, all right, hold it down for right today. Find a beat for it, and then, you know, when the beat come in, listen to the right beat for it, and then if it don't fit in, you know, I go in and adjust some shit, and it just start happening just like that. I usually rap what I see and what's really going on, but you know, as time go by, shit's changed. You gotta switch it up. You know what I'm saying? You gotta switch up the flow. You gotta switch up the topics. You gotta switch up all type of shit.
But even with you switching up, I still feel like you didn't switch up. Like, you still in that same wave. Because, you know, a lot of people making, like, cliche music. They just making, like, that drill music. You still giving us that South Florida, that.
Yeah, like, I'm more like a trendsetter. I hate the fact that, you know, see our city, like, copying other shit like that. Like, you know, at the end of the day, Miami, all you Miami listeners, man, this is where they want to be. This is where they want to be from. This is where they want to hang at. If you can see every artist that break, they always sending them over here to break. So we got to keep that shit original, man. I don't give a damn if it's from today or 10 Buck Motherfucker 2.
Real now.
You gonna hear this Miami shit come up out of me, man. I ain't finna lowball and try to switch up for nothing. Most people say I sound like a New York rapper, right? But at the end of the day, it's just that if you can be versatile with the style and the new age and the old age or whatever, this and that, you can do many things. You get what I'm saying? I ain't know I can sing, nigga. I'm singing that shit. Baby, I'm singing that shit.
Well, that's one of his videos right there that we showing to the people. Like, every time I look at your music, it just give me a different vibe. Like, I be more so on the, like, it just give me boss. You said you ain't the boss, you ain't the king.
I want you to see a video. One video I want to see, I'm ready to punch a nigga in the face. The next video is I'm ready to make love. The next video, I'm just hanging out. The next video, I want you to see that. Yeah, you just playing with this shit.
Hey, well, I'm talking about not the scenery of the video, like the vibe.
The vibe.
You give, like, you know, like, Ross give you, like, that cashmere sweaters. You know, shit that they ain't gonna put on. So when I hear your vibe and how the way you handle it, and you coming in, I'm like, he's just different.
I'm in the streets for real, so I'm gonna give you that street vibe, that hustling niggas and dying vibe, that how you come up from nothing, and when you come up, you show that this what you came up from. That's the type of vibe I want people to get from my music. Like, you ain't gotta be all bling bling chiseled down. You gotta show the struggle. You gotta show where you come from to where you going. You get what I'm saying? It can't just be, oh, this is what I came up with, all this bread. No, you got to show them crate days, man. You got to sit on the crate sometimes, sit on the block, do some shit on the block, eat some caviar, some shit. You know, you got to show them this shit right here, to show them that this shit was built, this shit wasn't made. You get what I'm saying? A lot of niggas have they rap, they style, and this shit look made already. You feel what I'm saying?
Shout out to Anthony McClear. He said, facts, bro. I feel like Alabama in the house.
Alabama, what they do?
We got Frank Castle here.
I fuck with Alabama now.
Yeah. So, like, what musician, like, who in the business that you feel like, you know, you admire their grind?
I ain't gonna lie.
Because before I said that, you like, already like, none.
I ain't gonna, no. Listen. It's a lot of them OGs in this game. I go for Master P. I go to Cash Money. Shout out to Birdman, you know. Birdman is a real nigga, you get what I'm saying? Birdman ain't know me from a can of paint. Birdman paid my appeal lawyer, you know what I'm saying? Like, he just being a real nigga, you feel me? Birdman.
Shout out to Birdman, too, because, you know, that was real.
I'm going to say a real name, Brian Williams Birdman, you feel me? A lot of niggas don't fuck with him, but I fuck with him, you know what I'm saying? You know, I look at the pioneers of this shit, who started this shit on black labels and shit like that. You know, it's up from Miami too. You got Ted Lucas.
Mm-hmm.
You got Po' Boy and they shit, you know, when they started. You know, I was young, you know, going to the skate ring and seeing all them niggas with Jordans screaming 5-5-5-5 shit. You know, they had Mr. Charlie back then and all that shit, Cognito. I used to be young in them stands and shit, watching how this shit building, you know. All the pioneers that started their own business and end up being successful. I don't care if a stop sign hit them somewhere down the line. They the ones who inspired me to do this shit to show, like, yeah, you can get this shit done. You can get an empire done, because you don't want to do it their way, but at the end of the day, you're going to get something done. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I get what you're
saying. So that wall inspired me to, like, really.
And that's a good thing, because you know what? Most people, when they come to the show and we ask them, like, who inspired them, they go send names. And there's no disrespect to those artists who inspired them.
Yeah.
But they send names to people who ain't putting no work. Like, who don't have they own, you know, they didn't patronize nothing in the industry. Everybody just about who you name, they patronize something.
Yeah, that's what
in this building.
And I feel like I want to leave you. I want to leave you with this too. I feel like, you know, it's a lot of us, like artists, like us coming up, and I always think that the big homies from the city supposed to put us on. But you gotta understand, it's Miami. You get what I'm saying? Miami is a challenging city. Like, it's a tourist city, but you gotta show that. You know what I'm saying? You ready to hold this shit down and make it not out the bucket, but make it out your situation the best way you can. Cause this shit is like, you know who and who you may know. You get what I'm saying? You never look out, never look up to who can help you help yourself. You get what I'm saying? And later on, your buzz could be bigger than Miami, my nigga. You a blow. Cause there's a lot of artists that came from Miami that blew outside of Miami before Miami.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So you gotta have that mindset. Think about outside of Miami before you think about Miami. You feel me? So.
But you rubbing shoulders with a lot of things.
Yeah, I feel like Miami. Shout out to all the big stations that are supporting me. You know, the local DJs that support me, the underground DJs. I want to send a major shout out to the underground DJs because they be the first ones to break artists. You get what I'm saying? And the local DJs and the underground DJs, and then they'll come and try to, you know, it's like, you gotta crawl before you walk. So, you know, shout out to the underground DJs, you know. I rub shoulders with a lot of people because I want to be a master of the game. I don't just want to be a student, I want to be a master. So, this shit don't work out, I can hold a seminar and tell you about how the process, how it goes. I could be a manager someday. You get what I'm saying?
Like, yeah, because like I remember speaking to manager. I remember you was talking to me one day. You was like, you know what? I see you different with like a lot of colors and a lollipop. Just change your style up. And I'm looking at him like, what? Nigga, I'm too gangster for that. And he was like, yeah, but I'm telling you, that different area. And then after he left, I was thinking about like, what this nigga on? How you gonna tell me?
You a gangster? Listen, you a gangster.
And he was really like, no, you need to calm it down. Like, I could see you doing something with a lot of colors and all this. And I was like, as he said it, I was rebellious to him. And then when I went, I'm driving home, I'm like, at first, I'm like, what this nigga castle on? Like, how you gonna tell a gangster to do some sweet shit?
I mean, you swagged up, my nigga. You already got what these rappers got, my nigga. Like, it might as well, like, you know. Show him, yeah, you gonna show him that gun and shit, but then show him that shit with color. You get what I'm saying? Put that shit live and live in color. You get what I'm saying? It's a lot that you female artists could do. You feel me? Just like, okay, I'm gonna speak on Meg real quick. Okay, Meg is from where she from, but I know they adapted some style from her to her shit. You feel what I'm saying? And I be watching it. Like, I watched your last video. I'm like, okay. I see you, okay, how you doing, this and that. I'm watching all the artists coming up in your video, all the female artists' video, and I'm like, damn, y'all gotta know, like, they take the juice from down here. All the juice come from down here. Y'all already got it, so y'all just gotta apply that shit. When y'all apply that shit, y'all push that shit to the motherfucking back.
Y'all have to apply that, because Griselda B has exited the building. Like, I don't want to rap. You see everybody sucking their teeth, they mad, because they really want me to do music.
She'll be back.
They think I'll be back. We gonna say shout out to Fat Boy, you know, cause he got this thing that I only rap during October, cause that's my birthday month. So that's when I come out in October. So you know, but I feel like this is my platform. This is what I like. I like to get in debt with artists who, you know, we always in the same thing. It's a stop sign for me. It keep going for you, like you say that. You know, you could be able to mentor somebody, manage somebody, and but throw seminars.
But you gifted, though. You blessed. Look at this right here, man. I've been told you need to open a podcast. Like,
you definitely told me that. Look at this, you say that all the time. You like to talk. You need to get a podcast. You did. It was important to bring you because your grind right now is unmatched. You've been grinding. You on the radio. You rub shoulders with people who in radio, like you on all these different flyers. Like you everywhere I look, I'm like, you know what? It's something like Big Bleak. Shout out to Blaze Carter too.
Blaze.
Like that, like y'all too, y'all be everywhere.
But you know, a lot of that with me came with, I had to take a lot too, you get what I'm saying? I had to take those, the disrespect, the talk behind the backs. Those, yeah, right now, whatever, nigga, later. You get what I'm saying? I had to take all that shit, you get what I'm saying? Because sometimes you approach people, they judge you by your cover, you get what I'm saying? They judge you by how you look. Like, you go up to a DJ. I had to deal with that shit, going up to a DJ. and asking the DJ, yo, could you spin my record? He looking at a nigga up and down and shit, giving a nigga the shoulder, and I had to stand up for a couple hours while I watched other artists come in the club. You call the other artist's name, and I've been standing here for hours, and I'm ready to pay you, and you ain't did shit, you get what I'm saying? I done been through that, so I feel like that's my gift.
Like, yo, dudes is paid.
Yeah, that's my gift, like, for, like, not even popping off on a nigga, you get what I'm saying? Like, so all that came with me grinding rubber shoulders, it been doors that been closed in my face, you know, how you take it. You get what I'm saying? A door closed in your face, another one opened up, you get what I'm saying? So
it's your dues paid. I could see it, like, I tell everybody.
I see your ass in cap.
I tell everybody, I know a lot of people, I'm not saying that, you know, I'm superior, but I like who I like. If you ain't that, you can't come on this show. Like, I like authentic.
Yo, we
like,
need
that
shit.
Like, I like realists. I like those who not following trends, those who not cliche. And you stayed in your own lane, you did your own thing.
We still doing it. We still
whatever,
doing it.
You know, for whatever time. So this is my thing, like, you know, being an artist, you got your strong suit, you got things that you ain't good at. You good at freestyling?
Yeah, but you know, I ain't feeling even freestyle right now.
I'm just saying, of course.
I don't put any beat on, I rip it, ain't nothing. You said that, give him a beat.
See, I like to put the money where the mouth. We don't care if you mess up, just catch it. See, that's what I wanted him to do. He ain't even see that coming. That was the uppercut that was in the sack.
Them boys already told me that. That's
oh, y'all said that?
Yeah.
Oh, who in here leaking out business? Yeah, oh, that what y'all told him?
I was already know about the freestyle.
Okay, go ahead and give him. We're going to give him a freestyle. I want all y'all who tune into this live. I want y'all to pay attention. I want y'all to drop them sites. We got the biggest 26er, the biggest Z. We got Frank Castle in the building. He going to go ahead and close this show out with a freestyle.
Man, shout out to everybody who's tapping in, who's tuned in, who's following me right now on Instagram, all platform. Hey Bay is out right now. You get what I'm saying? Hey Bay is out right now. Go ahead and cop that, you know, for the ladies. For me, go ahead and cop that. We got more videos we about to drop soon. Got my project coming out soon, Royal Castle. Stay tuned for that. You know, we doing it big on the Griselda Show.
Okay, y'all keep it locked here on the Griselda B Show. We'll be back with a quick break. I want you guys to stay tuned, and we will be right back. So let's go. We want you to go ahead and do it. Go ahead and do his. We want you to leave.
No.
He gonna run that back. We want you to go ahead and do you a.
What you doing, man?
Damn. I turned my camera off. Yeah, all that.
Oh. Let's go. And you don't even smoke. What you see?
I do smoke deep.
Go ahead.
Hey. 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 Hey, yo, hey, hey, listen, I say the feds still watching me, these niggas still snitching, shit. I'm still in their kitchen trying to get me a whipping, you niggas catching flashbacks when I come through, I'm the little hey saver, shout out what they do, yeah, Frank K, nigga with a great day, run through your block with that AK, shoot right in your face, you don't want to shoot fade, biggest nigga all day, ripping that MIA, 305 where I stay, little hey zone, I done told you before, I can knock down your door with this V54, drop the elbow, drop the bones and now drop clothes, when you see me, your shop stay closed, stop playing. Niggas laying, body be spraying, they saying, Frank Pan, ain't nobody be laying. I'm a type of nigga, come through your city, take over your city while I make you dip out like you did it. Fuck it, shoot your shots like 50. How you talking like 50 while I'm spraying on the semi? Niggas don't wanna see me, cause I'm real hemi. Have you ever seen something when it called stimmy? Hey, and my block collars here the two. If you want drama, they'll bring it straight to you. I don't talk shit, but I'll do what the hustlers do. Pull up the pounds and I'm grind like a hustler do. Cause I don't know where I'm from, so she know we rep the A5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, them zones stay live. 26 the name, so you know we came in real fire. She want me to rip this shit like french fries. My nigga say this shit was a hard pie. I was sitting in them crates, bro, was selling nothing but bean pies. My nigga say he want the shit, so we all live. He can give it to him, so I'ma give him 9 lives. Shoot his black ass down, nigga, I got 9 lives. Take you 9 times just to shoot up this black cat. I stay strapped and I stay lean back with a Joey cracker, making niggas lean back. You don't want that? Fuck that. I'ma rap to this. Stop, man.
Hey.
Shout out to Frank Castle, y'all.
Hey,
shout out to Frank Castle. He doing his thing. He doing the one. You know, like, he ripped it.
Off the dome. Niggas ain't coming in and do that shit. Niggas writing that shit.
Right. That's off the dome. Like, shout out to you. He came in. He murked it. Like, tell the people where they can find you at, how they can keep up with you.
Y'all can find me on Frank Castle 13. FrankKastle13 on Instagram. Follow me right now. You know what I'm saying? YouTube, same thing, Frank Castle 13. You know, check the videos out, run them numbers up. You know, shout out to all my supporters, shout out to my day ones, shout out to all the ladies out there, shout out to Grizzel the B. You know, shout out to Strong On Radio, shout out to the DJ.
Feel me? Shout out to my youngest that came to show support. Deliver.
Shout out to everybody that comment down there on that damn commentator right there. You feel me? Just like the stars looking at me, they looking at y'all too.
Listen, she say, GB, you excellent and Frank deliver. Shout out to Frank Castle. He killed it. We got his Instagram posted right there on the screen, y'all.
Shout
y'all
out to all you upcoming artists in Dade County. 2022 is our motherfucking year. Let's run these motherfucking out of town, out of our city, show how we really motherfucking get down.
Oh, yeah. So check it out, y'all. You know, one last question before we get out here, Frank. We want to know, for all the upcoming artists, what advice do you got to get them?
Keep fucking grinding, man. Stop. Listen. Push yourself, keep promoting yourself. I don't care if you got one motherfucking follower, one subscriber. Guess what? Keep pushing. That one subscriber gonna turn to two. That one follower gonna turn to two. Keep pushing, keep striving. Stop looking at your partners to support you. Nigga, this is a grind, nigga. The more you grind, the more you shine, my nigga. Do not be scared to put yourself out there. Promote yourself the best way you can. Love, hate, stand up, uptown, what it is. Y'all already know, 26-13-6, and we out.
Hello. Now that's been real. Now this is an incredible night. Like, we got Frank Castle came in the building. You did your thing. Like, we super proud of you, Frank. Like, keep on doing your thing. You got my support. I'ma always support you. Like, I see your grind. Your grind is unmatched. Like, you in the street. One thing I love about you in this business is you're not afraid to put someone else on. You're not afraid to put somebody else in your light.
No.
You connect with every artist came out of Miami. Frank Castle had something like he, you intertwined with that artist at some point.
Yeah, shout out.
From men to female.
On God. Listen, on God. Shout out to everybody that dropped the project from Miami this month, last month. Next month will be my month, man. Shout out to my boy Tafia. Put me on that video, man. I go get my boy Project, man. I go get my boy Kodak, the 26er Project right now. Going crazy. Y'all go support that fam right there. Y'all go ahead and just do the do. Do
so
what's
let
right.
Let them know when the new music dropping. When your project coming.
Hey, okay, we got, right now we got Hey Bae, you know, going crazy right now. Shout out to Rich Black. We got Hey Bae going crazy. That was for the ladies. Dropped the Valentine's Day. I dropped the mixtape. Check in season 26 volume 2 is out there right now, only 6 months, but you know we had a little problem with that, so now we still pushing that. So go tune into that. Check in season volume 1 is out, check in season volume 2 is out. You know, we're gonna do check in season 3 later on the year before after I drop the project. But everybody, man, shout out to all the club promoters that's booking me. The book dates is open. Holla at your boy. Shout out to every flight I've been on, every promoter that supported Frank Castle. We in this bitch, we ready to work. Let's get it.
It say your boy Redman say, what's up, Frank? Uptown for life.
You already know Redman. We in the bitty.
He come. They come in it. They come in it.
My little Haiti. My little Haiti young boy is coming, man. My little Haiti boy is coming, man. 400 coming. No block coming. Uptown coming. Little Haiti. Whole little Haiti coming. So I hope the industry ready for the whole little Haiti.
This been so good. We want to go ahead. You would see him, but you know you came in here with Frank Castle too. You know, before we close the show out, we wanted to say, you know, you want to say something about the people. I see you was hype when he just did this freestyle. He went crazy on his freestyle. Right. Yeah, so what you got to say about that?
He be doing shit like I be in the studio with him. And I ain't gonna lie, like I be telling him I want to rap and shit. He be like motivating me and shit he was just saying.
He did. Yeah, like, so why you don't rap?
Nah, not right now.
It's now or never, though. Like, you act like you got time.
I do got time. I'm a young boy.
No, you don't got time. This is the time.
Perfect.
So you just going to shatter him to see how the ropes go? Because one thing about it.
Now, he got a little something about.
Oh, they say 400 all day about to be home.
he got something about right now. And shout out to all my 26 and the chain gangs watching this right now, man. You know, y'all boys, man, read them songs. My nigga, keep God first, man.
Big shout out to Frank Castle. Like, I love the energy, Frank. Like, you came in here. You did your dollar. Like,
we had to.
I asked for a freestyle to put you on the spot like you weren't ready. And you blazing.
She just saw your sister looking at me like, nigga, come on. Like, you see how she looking like.
Shout out to Drink. You know, I gotta keep my baby by my side, man. Everybody know Drink. That's the girl. Long live Drink. We love you. And yeah, at the time that I lost my sister, you did lose your sister. We was kind of sharing the same pain.
You know what? I lost my dad. You lost your.